Welcome to Faults Learn. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to insert, update and delete data in GridView using Entity Framework in Visual Basic.net. To play the demo, we will design a simple UI that allows you to insert, update, and delete data from SQL database. Right-click on your project, then add an ADO.NET Entity Data Model to your project. Next, select your Northwind database, then select the customer table. If you don't have the Northwind database, you can download it from the FalseLearn website. As you know, Entity Framework is an object relational mapper, which is a type of tool that simplifies mapping between objects in your software to the tables and columns of a relational database. It's an open source ORM framework for ADO.NET, which is a part of .NET Framework. You need to add a binding source to your grid view. The binding source component is designed to simplify the process of binding controls to an underlying data source. The binding source component acts as both a conduit and a data source for other controls to bind to. It provides an abstraction of your form's data connection while passing through commands to the underlying list of data. Additionally, you can add data directly to it, so that the component itself functions as a data source. You can bind the binding source component to both simple data sources, like a single property of an object or a basic collection like ArrayList, and complex data sources, like a database table. The binding source component acts as an intermediary that provides binding and currency management services. At design time or runtime, you can bind a binding source component to a complex data source by setting its data source and data member properties to the database and table, respectively. If you want to cancel the operation, you need to filter all objects that have changed status, then check the status of each object.
Thank you for watching this video and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.